present tonight. God, you said in your word in Psalms 46 and 1, God is our refuge, a very present help in trouble. God, I thank you even when trouble is present, there's a dominant presence that's present, even above the trouble's presence. Hallelujah. And God, it's you. It is you. Make yourself known tonight, Holy Ghost. You said in Psalm 76 and 1 in Judah, God is known. In our praise, you are known, Holy Ghost. That's what Judah means. It means praise. So, Lord God, in our praise, you make yourself known tonight. And I thank you, Holy Ghost, that your wondrous works are nigh because your name is near. Psalm 75 and 1. Wherever the name of Jesus is spoken in faith, hallelujah, in expectation, the miraculous shall be associated with the speaking of that name. And we thank you. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus, through your name shall we track down those who rise up against us. Psalms 44 and 5. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus, for you have highly exalted him and given him a name above every name, that in the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, of things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth, and every tongue shall confess to the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah, that Jesus Christ is Lord. Philippians 2, 9 through 11. Thank you that the name of Jesus tonight is still sufficient and enough. You said your name is as precious ointment poured forth, Son of Solomon 1, 3, simply meaning your name is anointed. You will call his name Jesus, and he'll save his people from their sin. Matthew 1, 21. You said whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. John 2, in verse 32, said we call on you tonight, Lord Jesus, and we welcome your presence in this place tonight. You said in Hebrews 10, 19, wherefore, beloved brethren, having boldness entered into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Jesus, you shed your blood so we can enter the presence of God. I refuse to stay in the outer court. I deny to stay just in an inner court. God, I'm purposed tonight because of the blood to enter into the holiest of all. I refuse to leave this place until I come into a place where you're manifesting your power and presence and miracles. Lord Jesus, tonight if we have to linger, we linger. We don't leave, we cleave. Right now, Lord Jesus, until you manifest in this room with signs and wonders following, hallelujah, the believer, Holy Spirit, we thank you that that's being done even at this moment as we call upon the name of the Lord that's exalted tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, come and open our eyes that we may behold wondrous works in your law. Psalms 119, verse 18. Open our understanding, our perception. Help us see what's being said tonight. Holy Ghost, come on, pray that with me. God, help me see what's being said tonight. Hallelujah. Open our eyes, Holy Ghost. Amen. Take your Bibles tonight again. I said we're going to do things a little bit different. I want to actually give you a chance to turn somewhere, look up on the screen and see a scripture. Amen. Tonight, probably a title also. Hallelujah. Psalms chapter 126. Psalms chapter 126. We're going to read, amen, verses 1, and then immediately after that, well, I ain't going to say immediately because the early preacher might just get on before I go any further, but then we're going to go to Genesis 13. Genesis chapter 13, and we'll go from verse 14 through 18. Psalms 126 and verses 1. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's 26 and 1. That's a good one, too, but we can get a 1 before the 226, verse 1. Hallelujah. Psalms again, chapter 126, verses 1. There it is. Somebody say when. Didn't say if, it just said when, meaning there's a condition, there's a timing. God makes everything beautiful in his time. Amen. Please ask these three verses that it may not look too beautiful right now, but somebody say if you'll trust his timing, hallelujah, and if you'll serve him, amen, and walk with him, somebody shout, he'll change the times. Daniel 2:21 said he's the God that changes seasons and times. Psalms 31 said, my times are in your hand. Somebody shout, time's in his hand. Not just any time, but somebody say, my time. Come on, I'm going to participate in preaching tonight. Come on, come on, somebody speak back to us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, time's in his hand. Psalms chapter 126, rather, verses 1. When, meaning there's a time. The Lord turned. Somebody shout, a time to turn. Somebody shout, a turning time. Hallelujah. And I just go ahead and just pause right here on the platform of his prophesy, glory to God, and tell somebody that it's a time of turning. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, if you'll listen up tonight, God's going to turn some times around for you. Somebody shout, God's going to turn some times around. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, some times about to turn. Hallelujah. It's been a hard time, but somebody shout, it's about to become a better time if I'll just listen and obey. Come on, somebody. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Amen. He said, when the Lord turned again, somebody say again, ain't you glad we still serve the God of agains? The God of born again. Glory to God, if you were like the way he was born the first time, be born again. Because it said, be born again and not enter into the kingdom of heaven. John 3:3. Somebody may have to find me another mic because it's going to do all I can do, just stand still. Amen. That's something hard for me to do right now. Hallelujah. Somebody say, when the Lord turned again. Somebody say again. Thank you, Pastor. Hallelujah. Again. Amen. The captivity of Zion, we were like them that dreamed. Somebody say, we were like them that dreamed. We were like the dreamers. Somebody say, the dreamers. In other words, we see in this scripture that God says, when I turn their captivity again, when I turn the time, when I change the season of their captivity, amen, the sign, the indicator that they're free again is their dream. Y'all hear crickets?
Come on, man.
Let me do something. I'll just sit right here. That's what Revelation 1:18, Jesus said, I am he that was dead and alive forevermore. I have the keys of death and of hell. And the Bible said, Jesus said, amen. Even Jesus knew how to amen said. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So we see in the scripture, we see somebody that had past captivity. We saw that the people of Zion, God's children, were at one time bound in bondage and were captive, amen, to their season. Captive, amen, to some enemy. Captive to some situation. But when God turned again or delivered them, somebody shout, they became dreamers. Therefore, one of the indicators that you're bound up is you're dreamless. Somebody shout, if you can't dream, that's a sign there's bondage present. Come on, church. Somebody shout, when God liberates you, you become a dreamer. Hallelujah. Somebody say, a dreamer. I'm going to title this message tonight. The first part of the title is simply this: dreaming possessed. I didn't say demon possessed. I said dreaming possessed. Come on, somebody. Back in 2009, I was in a deep sleeping. I had just come off the road somewhere preaching. I can't remember the time. Amen. Where I was at, but I was tired. I'd been on the road. And I was sleeping hard, and I was having a dream. God was showing me something in this dream. And right in the middle of the dream, the figure of a demonic, unclean spirit appeared and began to force himself against what I was trying to dream and attacking what it was God was giving me in that dream season while I was sleeping of things to come. And the enemy was attacking. And all of a sudden, I was awakened, and I know some of you, amen, glory to God, probably going to think, man, he's a little out there. Hallelujah. You ought to try it sometimes, too. Praise God. Amen. And an audible voice awakened me. It called my name, and it sounded like running water. It had a lengthy extension to it, and it sounded like the wind. It was soft, but at the same time so heavy and masculine. That's the only way I know how to describe it. And it said like this, Marvin. And it awakened me. I thought, my God, and when I was awakened, I was in the presence of God. I was trembling, and I sat up in my bed, and the Holy Spirit, not audibly, but then spake in my spirit. He said, Marvin, there's an enemy that's after not just you, but it wants to stop the dream. Come on, somebody, that I've placed in your life, the thing that is destiny, the thing that I have anointed you to step forward and to go do for my kingdom and my glory and for the sake of souls being won. Somebody hear the Holy Ghost. And he said, Marvin, whatever you do, do not allow the enemy to cause you to become dreamless. Because if you stop dreaming, you will be in bondage. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And I heard that title the Holy Ghost gave to me. He said, stay dreaming possessed. When God turned their captivity, Somebody shout when they got out of bondage, it was because they were dreaming. Look at your neighbor and say, you can dream your way out. In Genesis chapter 37, verses 9, the Bible speaks about Joseph. And the Bible said when his brothers saw him, they said, oh, here comes that dreamer. This is Genesis 37, 19, rather. They said, oh, here comes that dreamer. That's all they could refer to their younger brother as, this old dreamer. Somebody said, this old dreamer. They said, here he comes. Somebody shout, here he comes. Somebody shout, that's what dreamers do. They keep coming. When the devil hits them, they come back. Somebody shout, if you'll keep dreaming, you'll come back. Somebody shout, you can make a comeback if you'll just keep dreaming again. Dream. And in Genesis 37 and verses 9, the Bible said he dreamed a dream. Glory to God. And then it said, he said, I dreamed a dream more. Somebody shout, he dreamed for the more. Hallelujah. Some of us, we can't dream for the more because we're so satisfied with the familiar. Somebody shout, there's some unclean spirits in our midst. There's some familiar spirits. That's what they're called. Somebody shout, spirits that deal with the familiar, where we get so satisfied with what we know. But Jeremiah 33:3 should call unto me, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things you know not of. Some of us has fell, amen, glory to God, amen, into a trap of patterns, where glory to God has been this way this long, and we've got so used to living this way so long. Some of us, what used to be a visitor, our struggle has now moved in with us, amen, and is now living with us. Look at your neighbor, say, don't allow the devil to become that one who stays. He may be a visitor right now. Trouble may be a visitor, but whatever you do, don't allow trouble to move in and take over. Come on, somebody, in the heart of you, the Holy Ghost.
We live in a day where we can't see the miraculous because so many are embracing the familiar. We're people of patterns. You don't believe it? If you come to church at least twice, you'll pick the second time you come the same spot you sit the first day. You'll pull up in the parking lot, you about lose your sanctification if you can't get your spot. We're creatures of habit. Hello, anybody hear the Holy Ghost? We get so caught up in the familiar. I tell you what, amen, sometimes that's good. There's a structure that comes along with that. There's a responsibility, amen, a maturing that comes along with that. I know, amen, but at the same time, if you ain't careful, amen, it can become a rut of routine. In Luke chapter 7, the Bible talks about Jesus raising a woman's young son from the dead. He walked up and touched the B-E-I-R. Somebody say the bar. That ain't the bar, but the bar. It was an open casket in that day. Amen. Glory to God. There was no lid on it. Sometimes there was not even an end on the ends. Amen. It was just an open box. And the deceased would lay there. And as they would go in the funeral procession, you could see, you could smell. Come on, somebody. The whole nine yards. There it was. And they would go, amen, to bury them. And Jesus walked up to the bier. He walked up to the casket. He walked up to the death. And he just touched the death. He just touched the bier. He just touched the casket. Hallelujah. And the dead boy stood up and started talking. Somebody shout, we need Jesus to touch our death again. We need him to touch the thing that's so familiar in our life. We got used to it being this way. Some of us have learned to live with it. I've come to help somebody stop learning to live and start learning to trust. You're so afraid to do anything different because you're in a rut of death. Amen. That's all rut is. It's a grave with the end stop out of it. It's a fire.